Hi guys, it's Mrs. Cameron here, and today we are going to take a look at the just released Algebra 1 EOC test from 2024. If you go to flfast.org and click on Florida Statewide Assessments, Students and Families, View Sample Items for Grades 3 to 10, Sign In as a Guest. I'm working with students taking retakes in 11th and 12th grade, so I'm going to say 12th grade. And you come down here, 2024 released tests. We're going to take a look here at the Algebra 1 EOC released test. This is just how the test will look. Usually leave the settings alone. When you're looking at this screen, you can see the questions here, and you can see the reference sheet. We'll be looking at the reference sheet for some questions. And you can see that Florida has the decimals calculator embedded in the test. So I'll show you how to pull up this calculator. To make it easier so that I can write on this, I have a PDF copy of these test questions. On this tab here, same questions that are on the practice test online. And over here, when you go to desmos.com, you click on Math Tools, Test Practice, Choose Assessment, Florida. Even though it says the old name of the test, if you compare this calculator to the calculator on the test, all of the buttons are in the same place. Everything matches. So this is the calculator that I use with my students in my class when we are practicing for the Algebra EOC. And let's get right into the first question. This says, in baseball, a pitcher's earned run average is used to measure how effective the pitcher is. The earned run average, A, is calculated using the formula shown, where E is the number of earned runs and N is the number of innings the pitcher pitched. A equals 9E over N. Which equation correctly solves the formula for the variable E? A question like this, you need to remember your rules for rearranging variables. We have A equals 9E over N, and we want to get the E isolated, the E only by itself. So what's with the E is a 9 and an N on this side of the equation. I'm going to start by saying, okay, what's the easiest part to cancel out or get rid of over here with my E? And I would say it's the N. What is my N doing to the E? And since it's under fractions, it means that it's dividing. What's the opposite of dividing? Is multiplication. So I'm going to multiply this side of the equation by n, and our properties of equality says that if I do that on this side, I have to multiply this side as well. And you could put it in parentheses or not, just na. And then your multiply by n and divide by n are going to cancel each other out. Now I'm going to rewrite it underneath. I don't really need that word problem information up top. I know where I'm going. We're just rearranging variables. Now I have NA equals 9E. And I still want to get the E isolated, the E only by itself. What's with the E? It's a 9. What is the 9 doing with the E? There's no addition or subtraction sign. There's no fraction, which means the 9 and the E are multiplying. What is the opposite of multiplication? It is division. So if I want to cancel out my 9 and leave the E, then I need to divide by 9. And properties of equality says whatever I do on one side of the equal sign, I have to do on the other. That's going to make my 9s cancel out. Now my E is only by itself on this side, so I know that E equals NA over 9. And my answer that says that E equals NA or AN over 9. I'm allowed to multiply in either order, so they just have the A and N on different sides, but it's equal to my answer. So I know I've got this question right. I can come over here. I didn't need the calculator for that. Lock in my answer and then go on to the next question here. And when you're here, oh, I almost forgot. While you're practicing this, if this is something that you're not real comfortable with and you think, oh gosh, I wish I had some more practice on rearranging variables, I do have an IXL lesson prepared that you can practice. If you're a current student in my class, then we worked on this already. So if you have an IXL account through your personal account or through your school account, the code for the lesson on rearranging variables is WSJ, and that's the Algebra 1 rearranging variables code in IXL. I'm going to continue adding videos to this playlist with practice on the remaining 44 questions available in that practice test. I hope that this is helpful to you, and on the next video, we will continue going through the next questions. I'm rooting for you. I hope you pass this test. Have a good one.